Hello everyone, welcome to another video. In this video we're going to test two different thermal paste on my GPU. One is a cheap generic thermal paste that costed me around 50 cents, and on the other hand we have a basic branded thermal paste from Cooler Master that costed me around $5. Let's see how much difference we can make with the basic branded thermal paste, and also are cheap thermal pastes good enough. Let's find out. Let's just go with the cheap one first. Okay, so our graphics card is installed. Let's play Shadow of the Tomb Raider and record some temperatures. The starting temperature of GPU was 41 degrees Celsius, but it rose to 51 when I started screen recording. That's a huge jump. Let's see how much this thermal paste can hold on. Our GPU is already at 70 plus on game menu. The game kicked off with 78, 79 degrees and it seems kind of stable now. Let's play it for half an hour and see the change. For playing half an hour, our GPU temperature is around 81, 82 and our game is running completely fine. When I turned off the game, MSI Afterburner indicates that the max temperature went to 83 while it went down to 56 to 57 after turning off the game. So these were the temperatures for cheap thermal paste. Started with 50 degrees stable without gaming. Peaked to 83 degrees during the game, went back to 57 degrees after gaming, while fans were running at 56%. Now let's apply the branded Cooler Master thermal paste and record the temperatures. The GPU started with 40 degrees, but it got stable around 47 when I started screen recording and not going up to 51 degrees. Let's run our game. So our game started with 69 degrees and it is jumping around 69 to 70. These are initially much better results. Let's play for half an hour again and see how much the temperature can rise. I think the water powers.
Strange beasts cross our hero's path. Hard to tell if they're bloodless.
After half an hour, GPU temperatures is still around 71 to 72 degrees, which is far, far better than
now
previous temperatures. Turning off the game, the temperature quickly dropped to 60 degrees and kept going down while fans were running at 48%. MSI Afterburner indicates that the max temperature our GPU hit was 74 degrees. Now let's quickly jump to the conclusion. Cheap thermal paste started with 41 and rose to 51, while on branded thermal paste it started with 40 and rose to 47. Game temperatures stabilized around 81 degrees for cheap one and 71 degrees for branded one. The max temperature on cheap was 83 degrees and on branded the max temperature was 74 degrees. So roughly there was a 10 degrees difference between the two. The conclusion is, don't buy cheap thermal paste and put your CPU or GPU at risk. Try to purchase even the most basic branded thermal paste available in the market. There's a reason why branded thermal paste are expensive, but the one I used from Cooler Master is one of the most basic and cheap branded thermal paste available in market. Well, thanks for watching guys. I hope it helped you a lot. If it does, make sure to subscribe my channel and give this video a like. Also share this video in your circle. I'll see you in the next video.